Hi, in this video, we will discuss about Sutherland-Hogman polygon clipping algorithm. We can define polygon as a closed figure described by a set of line segments. Consider this example. We have three line segments, 1, 2 and 3. The first and starting point and the last point are same, so we are getting a closed figure. We want to clip this particular one against the window. So we have defined already clipping as identifying the part of the image which lies inside the window boundary and removing the part of the image which lies outside the window boundary. So we have learned line clipping. If we apply line clipping for this polygon, we may be left with three line segments and the final output may look like this, a fragment of a polygon. But a polygon clipping algorithm should result in one or more closed figures like this. To achieve this, Sutherland-Hogman proposed a polygon clipping algorithm. So this polygon clipping algorithm, we have a polygon may intersect with more than one window boundary, and also we have to clip this against each and every boundary, like the input image should be given as input for four clippers like this, left, right, bottom and top, and the final output may be the clipped image. So we will see how to apply this Sutherland-Hogman polygon clipping. To start with, let us see how to represent a polygon inside a computer. We have a polygon which is represented as a set of vertices V1, V2, V3 and V4. And the edges can be represented as V1 to V2, V2 to V3, V3 to V4 and V4 to V1. So now we want to clip this polygon against this window boundary. So when you want to clip this window against the window boundary, we can have four cases. That is, the first case is outside to inside. That is, we have to analyze the adjacent vertices V1, V2, V2, V3, V3, V4 and V4, V1. The first cases we'll just take it as V1, V2. This I call it as inside and this I call it as outside. So the first point V1 is outside, the second point V2 is inside. So we say outside to inside. Then we have to say the point of intersection, let me call it as V1 dash and the second point, that is V2. Second case is inside to inside. Example, V2 to V3. If both the points are inside, then we have to say only the second point. Let me say V3. This is V3. Next case is outside, inside to outside. That is, the example is V3 to V4. So V3 is inside, V4 is outside. In this case, you have to say only the point of intersection. Let me call it as V4 dash. The last case is outside to outside. The example is V4 to V3. Both the points are outside. In that case, we don't want to save any point. So if you apply these steps, the clipped polygon will be like this. That is V1 dash, V2, V2, V3, V3, V4 dash. So here we represent this cases in a simplified table. This I will carry over for the next clipping steps. Let us consider this particular example with the vertices V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 and the edges V1 to V2, V2 to V3, V3 to V4, V4 to V5, V5 to V1. I want to clip this particular polygon against this window. You can observe that the polygon is intersecting with all the four boundaries of the window. So this particular polygon should be given as first input to your left clipper. So this is your polygon. Now you have to clip this particular polygon against the left boundary of a window. So whatever is on the left hand side of this particular boundary, I call it as out. Whatever is on the right hand side of the boundary, I call it as in. So let us start with the first point V1 and the second point V2. V1 to V2. So when you say V1 to V2, V1 is outside, V2 is inside, out to in. So out to in means you have to store the point of intersection and the V2. So I'll store these two points, V1 dash and V2. V2 to V3. It is into in. Into in means you have to store only the second point. I'll store the second point. V3 to V4. Into in. We store only second point. V4 to V5. That is into out. Into out means you have to store the point of intersection. Let me call it as V5 dash. So I'll store V5 dash. So like this, when I store my values, next one is V5 to V1. Both are outside, so nothing is stored. So when I just store all these values, my left clipper will leave a polygon like this. This should be given as an input for my right clipper. So right clipper should clip the polygon only against the right window. So this is considered as in, and this I call it as out. So I have to start from V1 dash. V1 dash to V2. Here in and in, both are in, so we have to store only V2. Second point, V2 to V3. Both are in, so we store only V3. Then V3 to V4. V4 is in, V3 is in, V4 is out. That is into out. So we have to store the point of intersection. So we have to store V4 dash the point of intersection. Now, next one is V4 to V5, that is out to in. In out to in, we have to store the intersection point and the second point. We store V4 double dash and V5 dash. Next one is V5 dash to V1. So V5 dash to V1 is in to in. So we just store only the second point. So that is V1 dash. So after applying right clipper, we'll be left with this polygon with these vertices. This should be given as input to my bottom clipper. So in bottom clipper, whatever is below this line is out. Above this line, I call it as in. And I have to start with V2 to V3. V2 to V3. So V2 is inside and V3 is also inside. So we have to store only the second point, into in. Next one, V3 to V4, into in. So we store the second point. Then V4 dash to V4 double dash, into in. So we store only the second point. V4 double dash to V5 dash. Now this is in, this is out. Into out. Into out means you have to store the point of intersection, that I call it as V5. Already dash is there, so I call it as double dash. V5 double dash. Now V5 dash to V1 dash, this is out and this is in. Out to in means I have to go for this condition, so I store V5 triple dash and V1. Then V1 dash to V2, we have to store only the second point, into in. So we'll be getting V2. So the output of the bottom clipper will be like this with these vertices. And this should be given to the final and last clipper, that is top clipper. So whatever is below this line will be taken as in, above this line will be taken as out, and we start with V3 comma V4 dash. V3 and V4 dash means V3 is out, V4 dash is in. Out to in means you have to store intersection point and the second point. So we store V3 dash and V4. Then V4 dash to V4, into in. So we store the second point. Then V4 double dash to V5 double dash, into in. So we store second point. V5 double dash to V5 triple dash, into in. So we store the second point. V5 double dash to V1, into in. So we store the second point. V1 dash to V2, we have into in. So we store only the second point. V2 to V3, into out. When you say into out, you have to store the point of intersection. We call it as V3 double dash. So the output of this polygon and we'll be left with this type of output. So this is your clipped polygon output, which is also a polygon with these many vertices and edges. Now let us summarize the algorithm. So we have to apply a polygon. The polygon may intersect with more than one window boundary, so we have to clip it against all the window boundaries. Each adjacent vertices are tested against the boundary. Now we have four cases exist. Case one, outside to inside, means we save the point of intersection in the second point. Inside to inside means save only the second point. Inside to outside means save only the intersection, and outside to outside means no need to save the point. So we have to give the input to a left clipper and right clipper. Output is given to the bottom clipper. The final output will be the from the top clipper. This is your Sutherland-Hogman polygon clipping algorithm. For more details, you can read Computer Graphics by Hernan Becker. Have a nice day.